Imagine you're a ship merchant, and you've spent 20 years of your adult life trading back and forth from place to place across the seas, and then one day, a vicious storm sinks your ships, and you lose everything. You lose your entire life's savings and your entire life's work in one day. What would you do? You just lost everything. Would you ask God, why have you done this to me, God? Why? Why me, God? Would you sink into a depression for a long time? Just give up, you know? Well, this is the story of Zeno of Citium, the founder of the Stoic philosophy. When that happened to Zeno of Citium, instead of cursing the gods and becoming depressed for a really long time, he had the epiphany, a world-changing epiphany, that to lament over things and circumstances that are outside of our control is a truly fruitless endeavor. And it is within our control, it is our choice whether or not to lament over them. Instead of giving up or starting over as a merchant, he took the event as an opportunity to change his course in life and started teaching his philosophy, the philosophy of Stoicism in Athens. And that eventually led to being one of the most popular and influential philosophies in all of ancient Rome. The ancient Roman emperor Marcus Aurelius was a student of the Stoic philosophy and is now most well known for his writings in his journal. Writings that he never expected anyone else to see, writings to himself, advice to himself, words for himself to live a better life. Although he was an emperor of one of the most powerful empires in history, the advice therein in his journal was relatable and very relevant even today. The lesson that Zeno of Citium learned that day when his ships sank is captured perfectly in one of the quotes by Marcus Aurelius. You have control over your mind, not outside events. Understand this, and you will find strength. The first of the four virtues of Stoicism that we're discussing today is wisdom, seeing things as they are and not how we want them to be. And this, in essence, is captured perfectly in another famous Stoic quote by Epictetus. He said,
"Do not seek for things to happen the way you want them to. Rather, wish that what happens happened the way it happens. Then you will be happy."
Zeno of Citium saw losing his life savings and his entire life's work for what it was, which was a circumstance that was outside of his control. And he knew that worrying about it, getting angry about it, or depressed about it wouldn't do anything for him. The second virtue is courage. And another quote by Marcus Aurelius that perfectly encaptures this is,
"Keep this thought handy when you feel a fit of rage coming on. It isn't manly to be enraged. Rather, gentleness and civility are more human, and therefore manlier. A real man doesn't give way to anger and discontent, and such a person has strength, courage, and endurance, unlike the angry and complaining. The nearer a man comes to a calm mind, the closer he is to strength."
The third virtue is justice. And here's another quote from Marcus Aurelius to explain that.
"Does what's happened keep you from acting with justice, generosity, self-control, sanity, prudence, honesty, humility, straightforwardness, and all other qualities that allow a person's nature to fulfill itself? So remember this principle when something threatens to cause you pain. The thing itself was no misfortune at all. To endure it and prevail is great good fortune."
The fourth and final virtue is temperance. And one more quote from Marcus Aurelius that perfectly explains what temperance in Stoicism is all about.
"Stop allowing your mind to be a slave, to be jerked about by selfish impulses, to kick against fate and the present, and to mistrust the future."
Stoicism teaches us that if we live by these four virtues, then it's possible for anyone, whether it be someone born a slave, like Epictetus, or someone who is an emperor, like Marcus Aurelius, to achieve eudaimonia. Eudaimonia breaks down into two root words, eu, meaning good, and daimon meaning spirit. So eudaimonia means good spiritedness, and anyone can achieve eudaimonia by living these four virtues. Stoicism teaches us that ultimately, no matter what the circumstances are, it is a choice to remain in good spirits, because it is a choice and always under our control to live by these four virtues. Therefore, it is always a choice to be in good spirits, no matter what happens. Here is another great quote from another famous Stoic, Seneca.
True happiness is to enjoy the present, without anxious dependence upon the future, not to amuse ourselves with either hopes or fears, but to rest satisfied with what we have, which is sufficient. For he that is so wants nothing. The greatest blessings of mankind are within us and within our reach. A wise man is content with his lot, whatever it may be, without wishing for what he has not.
I'll wrap this one up with another reminder. The Stoic practice of memento mori, or remember death. We're all going to die one day, so we should live lives that we can proudly look back upon when that day arrives. If you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Alrighty, bye-bye.